Tune in to this week's Xamarin Essential API of the Week, where I show you how to use the SMS API, where you can send an SMS. So tune in. Welcome back, everyone, to another Xamarin Essentials API of the Week. Today, I'm going to show you how to use the SMS API to launch the default SMS or text messaging application from your application. This is great if you're building a chat application, or maybe you have a kind of employee directory or a conference application or just a business application where you want to have your users text your business or one of your employees or something like that. It's a very simple API to use, so let's take a look at how to get started. Here I am inside of Visual Studio, and as always, I have my app Xamarin Essentials with all of the different APIs in it. I've installed Xamarin Essentials into all of my projects, iOS, Android, and my .NET standard library. That gives me access to all the APIs. Now, if you've been reading our documentation or used Xamarin Essentials before, you'll know there's just one more little thing you need to do for Android specifically, which is go in and initialize Xamarin Essentials and also set up the permissions. This is going to handle everything for you. Now, to emulate the SMS API, I've created a very simple page where I can enter a phone number, I can go ahead and enter a message to pre-populate, and a send. So let's go ahead and see how to implement this in the back end. In the code behind, I'm just gonna say using Xamarin.Essentials, there we go, and that's gonna give me access immediately to all of the different APIs. So down here, we can go ahead and zoom in on that button click, and I could have said Xamarin.Essentials. And got access to all those different APIs. And we'll see down here, here is the SMS API. So let's go ahead and type in SMS dot. And we'll see that there's a single asynchronous API to launch the default SMS client, and it's compose async. So here, we can go ahead and just compose and launch the SMS client without any information. So if you just want to open the SMS app, or we can pass it an SMS message. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll say SMS message, and we'll go ahead and fill it in. There are two different parameters here. So for instance, the first one is body. So we'll say equals entry message.text. And the other one here is recipients. So this recipients, if we go ahead and take a look at what that is going to be a list of strings. So in this instance, we could create a new list of string, and we could go ahead and pre-populate it with any number we want. So if we wanted to here, we could say entry number.text. There we go. And go ahead and close that off. Now we'll notice that there's some green squigglies because it's asynchronous here. So we want to go ahead and await on this. And now everything's happy. Now there's one extra thing that I want to note here is that while technically we're passing in an SMS message, I should also note that you don't have to create it this way. We could have simplified this a little bit too. Instead of creating it with the properties there, there's some additional constructors. One takes in a body and a single recipient or an IEnumerable. So for instance, we could say entry message.text, and then we could say entry number.text there. There we go. That kind of makes it a little bit easier if you don't want to construct a brand new list. Now, with that single line of code, we're kind of ready to go. Now, I will say you'll probably want to add a try-catch statement here. And the reason for that is because there's a possibility that there may not be an SMS application, or maybe something's malformed inside of that phone number. So it's always best practice to do a try-catch and then handle that inside your application. But that's it, a single line of code. We're gonna go ahead and wait on it and then go from there. We'll remove this throw, but we'll just go ahead and let it go from here. Now I'm gonna debug our application. This is gonna compile it up and then launch it on my physical Android device. Now I'm putting it on my Android device, or it could be an iOS device because it actually has SMS applications and capabilities on it. So let's go ahead now that our app has launched, and we're going to go into the SMS section. Here we'll enter a phone number, so we'll say 1-555-555-5555. Good phone number. And that's the phone number that we'll be sending the text message to. And I'll say, hello from Essentials. There we go. And hit send. Now, it's going to prompt me what application would I like to send it with. And this is going to happen on Android the very first time your users use this functionality in your app. Because on Android, there's multiple applications that could have an SMS response. On Android, this will just launch the SMS application there. So it'll handle it automatically. Now, once I select one, that will become my default. And it would launch it again. Here, we're going to go ahead and say, yeah, we'll use this application. And here, once I've set it up, as you can see, it's my very first time texting on this phone. It's pre-populated on top with the 555 number, and it says, hello from Essentials. And I can send that message out to my friend at this phone number. That's it. It's really that easy to start sending SMS messages from your application using the default SMS application on your user's device. I hope that you like this Xamarin Essentials API and all of the other Xamarin Essentials API of the Week videos. So make sure that you subscribe on YouTube and on Channel 9 for all the updates every single week. And until next time, I'm James Montemagno. This has been Xamarin Essentials API of the Week, and thanks for watching. Hey, it's James. I'm just checking in and wanted to thank you for watching this awesome Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Now, don't forget to do all the things, such as like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell for even more videos. And while you're here, check out more Xamarin Essential API videos of the week. They're all right here. Go do it right now. It's awesome.